Sorry to interrupt for fun, gentlemen, but long-range sensors have picked up something interesting.
Concentrated mass of oxygen and hydrogen. Lots of animal and plant life.
An M-class planet?
No, that's the interesting part.
We're entering visual range.
That's great.
What is it?
It's an ocean.
According to these readings, it's bigger than the Atlantic and Pacific combined.
What's holding it together? Looks like there's some sort of containment field keeping it from dissipating.
Take us in closer, Tom.
Are those starships or submarines?
Open a channel. This is Captain Janeway of the starship Voyager. Please identify yourselves.
They are powering weapons.
Shields. Red alert.
Shields holding, no damage. Should I return fire?
Not yet. Voyager to approaching vessels. We have no hostile intentions.
They're maintaining their course.
Target the lead ship and take out their weapons.
Direct hit.
They're hailing.
Guess we got their attention. On screen.
I'm Deputy Counsel Burkus of the Monean Maritime Sovereignty. You violated our space. Withdraw or we'll resume firing.
Counsel, we could have destroyed your ships, but we didn't. We have no interest in a fight.
And why are you here?
Because we're explorers, and we're fascinated by your ocean. And we'd like to learn more about it and your people, if you'd be willing.
And if we're not?
We'll be disappointed, but we'll leave you alone.
Your ship's impressive.
Well, I'd be happy to give you a tour.
Forgive our vigilance, Captain. Over the years, my government has had to protect our ocean from more than one hostile species.
I understand. We're also very protective of our own natural resources.
About new cultures. Yours sounds particularly fascinating.
And this is Voyager's command center. Feel free to have a look around.
I'm curious, Consul. Have your people always lived here?
Our ancestors were nomadic. They only discovered the waters 300 years ago.
I'll bet they were as stunned as we were to find this huge ball of water floating in space.
Yes. Mr.
Paris, Tom Paris.
My first officer, Commander Chakotay.
They realized they could farm sea vegetation, extract oxygen from the ocean for their ships, create a permanent home.
What's your population?
More than 80,000.
And you all live underwater?
Lieutenant, we do have other business to attend to.
Mr. Tuvok, escort our guest to the briefing room. Care to join us, Mr. Paris?
How could you tell?
Do you still live aboard your ships?
We've built an industrial infrastructure and undersea dwellings, but yes, most of our people still choose to live as our ancestors did.
Any idea how the ocean came into existence? In my experience, it's a unique phenomenon.
Riga?
There are several theories. Our clerics teach that the ocean was a divine gift from the creators to protect and sustain us. But in my opinion, the most plausible explanation is that the ocean formed naturally, much the same way that a gas giant does.
Makes sense.
Unfortunately, our limited knowledge of the phenomenon has created a few problems.
What do you mean?
I'm not sure this is an appropriate topic.
But they might be able to help us.
We'll do anything we can.
The ocean's losing containment. Hydro volume has decreased more than 7% in the last year alone.
Any idea what's causing it?
No. To make a thorough study, we'd need to explore the ocean center, where I believe the gravitational currents are fluctuating.
But that's more than 600 kilometers deep.
Our best research vessel can only go 100 kilometers. Beyond that, the pressure's too great.
Well, we could take you there. Captain?